Hello there. Since you're watching this video, it seems that you're interested in learning about Pinewood Computer Core. Whether you only just joined or have been playing for a long time, I'll tell you as much as I know about the game.
So, how did this all start? Pinewood started at a very early time, being founded on May 15th, 2008, less than 2 years after Roblox first opened to the public. To put this into perspective, Pinewood is older than things like Trollface, Row Row Fight the Power, and 94% of Roblox users. At this time, Pinewood used to be called Pinewood Labs, and started off with the Roblox Power Plant. After some time, the first Pinewood headquarters opened up in December of 2008. A month later, Pinewood rebranded to the familiar Pinewood Builders. Under the new name, the Pinewood Research Facility opened in February 2009. Throughout 2009, Diddleshot, the creator, opened more and more games under the Pinewood name until October 30th, 2009. On this day, Pinewood Computer Core opened on Roblox. Although the game has been around for a long time, the earliest known footage of Pinewood Computer Core was recorded on March 31st, 2011 by a YouTuber named Axlog. Click here to watch it. It only took until December of 2014 for Pinewood Computer Core to reach its first million place visits. Very slowly, it began to grow a bit faster, with the game reaching 5 million visits by July 2018, followed by a large burst in popularity that caused the game to reach 10 million in June 2019, 20 million in February 2020, and 30 million in February 2021.
So, what is this place exactly? Pinewood Computer Core is labeled to be a modern futuristic facility roleplay game where you can either protect or destroy the facility via causing the nuclear reactor in the center of it all to explode. What exactly is the point of the game? Are you supposed to protect it or destroy it? Well, not even the creator really cares about it. As I simply just said, do what you want. However, gameplay isn't just as simple as wanting to blow up or destroy the facility. There is possible lore sprinkled throughout the game that might connect it to the parent company, Pinewood Builders, or other Pinewood games, but let's not get into that today. Now, about the two main gameplay aspects, let's talk about it. The Meltdown is one of the two main ways to destroy the facility. It was added all the way back in February 2013, and in order to activate it, you have to heat up the core to 4,000 degrees. Now, I would show the whole thing, but I already made a video on it, so go click on that. In the meantime, here's a quick summary on how to do it. Number 1, disable coolant supply. This also disables this button in admin control. Number 2, shut off the fans. There's 5 overhead fans adjacent to the admin control room, so turning it off is relatively easy, as there is a room right adjacent to those fans that allow you to easily just turn it off. 3, power on all lasers. Just underneath the fans is the main core room. By entering the core mainframe, you can reach where the reactor core itself is. Surrounding it is a bunch of laser buttons. Turn on all 6 of them, and you'll start to heat up the core much faster. The final step is to turn the reactor power all the way up. In order to do this, you have to simply fall into the little hole underneath the reactor core and enter a nearby hallway. Right at the end of that hallway is 4 buttons, each of which represents a level of reactor power. By selecting 4, that selects the max, and therefore should heat it up faster. And that's how you cause a meltdown. However, you might want to bring a group with you, since there are going to be quite a few people that might want to stop you if they want a freeze down or if they're trying to save the core, so be careful of that. Once the core temperature reaches 4,000, then the meltdown procedure will begin and the facility will be destroyed very shortly. However, the meltdown procedure can be stopped by filling the e-coolant to sufficient levels before a certain timer runs out. If the timer runs out and the e-coolant is not at the levels that the game expects it to be, then the meltdown fully begins and you better head to the launch silos. The Freezedown, being added in December of 2018, is an extremely easy concept to grasp, as it is literally the polar opposite of a meltdown. So I'll just run it down real quick. Coolant, on. All 5 fans, off. Lasers, off. Reactor power, 1. And there you go. Just like before, you'll get that freeze down in no time, as long as nobody stops you. So just get the core down to negative 4,000 degrees, and the meltdown procedure will begin, a black hole will spawn and destroy the facility. Click here to watch that. It's not just that though. Besides core destruction, the game has expanded a lot over the past 13 years and allows you to do way more things. Some examples are driving a train, trolling people with a nuke train, survive the 7 random events, become a zombie, fall into the core, crash into the super important support beam, glitch out of the map, spy on people through the cameras, have lunch, get electrocuted, enter the first code, enter the second code, try to figure out the third code, which you won't, and escape the facility. You can also just do this, apparently. Rocket train! Now, why is there always a battle between destroying and saving the core? Well, this simply boils down to the two main groups that inhabit the server. The Pinewood Builder security team, tasked with keeping the core and facility safe, and the Mayhem Syndicate, who cause mayhem and attempt to blow up the facility. Each group has a large member count, with PBST having over 150,000, and TMS having almost 40,000. So, what are the point of these groups? Well, every so often, there's an event where PBST protects and TMS raids. So, it's basically just normal gameplay, but with more organization, I guess. Pinewood Computer Core is a very large game with many areas to explore. The facility itself is divided into 7 sections. Each of these sections is labeled based on a letter from A through G. There are also 3 zones and a bunch of minor areas as well. Here's a quick summary of everything. Sector A. Sector A contains the spawn, the shop, the train station, the core room, and the cargo bay. Sector B. Sector B is all the stuff in this area. It consists of the Pinewood Emergency Team Headquarters, the Computer Science Lab, and the Medical Room. Sector C. Sector C is more commonly traveled than Sector B, as it holds the Admin Control Room above the core. It also has the PBST Room, this elevator, and the lunch silos. Sectors D and F. Sectors D and F simply consist of the server rooms. Sector E doesn't exist. Don't ask me why. It just doesn't. Sector G. Emergency coolant. It's where you ruin a meltdown for people. Fun! Zone 1, the first of the 3 zones. Zone 1 is mostly just the cargo area, but it also includes the launch silos, or Zone 1E. Zone 2 and 3. The last 2 zones are small, as Zone 2 are these caverns, and Zone 3 is a parking lot. Finally, the areas that aren't part of a sector are the coolant sector, the escape room, and the various train stations. You can visit every single one of these on foot, but you can also take a train if you like. I would recommend walking, as trains can get pretty chaotic sometimes. A very well-known part of Pinewood Computer Core are the 3 codes that you can put into the core mainframe. The primary code is the easiest of the 3 codes to know, especially since the game announces it over and over again on the loudspeakers.
Today's security code is 5-33-41-18.
The secondary code is also pretty easy to guess, as each digit in it is 1 digit above the first code, and also part of it is on this clipboard as well as the first one. The tertiary code is the rarest code. Only people in the Pinewood Intelligence Agency and very few outside of it have been able to guess the code correctly, which allows for cringy Roblox YouTubers to clickbait the hell out of it. It just makes you wanna... I've talked about it before on my Pinewood Rare Events video, but essentially entering the third code starts the Supernova event. Nobody really knows what this event is, as every single time the third code has been entered, it's simply just an admin typing semicolon S. You can guess the third code all you want, but you can't, unfortunately. As I mentioned earlier, there are 7 random events that occur throughout the game. If you survive them, it gives you 2 credits. Excluding meltdowns and freezedowns, those events are the alien dance parties when a group of aliens visit the facility and just have a dance party for a few minutes before leaving. Dancing with the aliens gives you a badge. Radiation pipe leak is one of the events that affect the core chamber, as a pipe bursts and floods the core chamber with a radioactive substance. In order to fix it, you must have a hazmat suit from the PET headquarters and open each of the 4 radiation drains. Rising plasma is the second event that happens in the core chamber. This event starts when the core becomes unstable and releases plasma. Anyone near the core dies, and plasma fills the core chamber until it decides to go away. The final event in the core chamber is the newest magma event. Supposedly this is rare, but I've seen it so many times that I don't really think it is. And that's why I excluded it from my Pinewood Rare Events video. Similar to the plasma event, magma leaks from a hidden Zone 5 and fills the core chamber until it goes away. It actually rises higher than radiation in the plasma, so watch out. The blackout is a basic event where power in the facility goes out. This is the only other event that players can fix themselves, as you can turn the power on using the emergency generators until main power is restored. You also can't use the generators if those fuel trains didn't give it fuel. Neurotoxin is another basic one where toxic gas escapes into the ventilation system. Just stay away from vents until it ends, it's really not that hard. The earthquake event is the only natural disaster that occurs to the facility. No, it doesn't actually destroy the building, it just kinda shakes your camera view and also derails trains. So if you're driving a train during an earthquake, stop it right now. For you Pinewood newcomers, I hope you guys enjoyed listening and learning about such a unique and interesting Roblox game. If you're a longtime player and didn't really learn much new, that's great too! Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the game. Bye!